Hi, so today I'm going to show you a flexible solar panel. Now when you think of solar panel, you might be thinking of something like this, which is your regular solar panel with the aluminium frame. It's a little bit heavy, it takes some serious mounting hardware, but that's not what I'm talking about. What I'm talking about is one of these new flexible solar panels. Now this one, you can see it just rolls up like this, and you literally just unroll it. Now the good thing about this is, aside from the fact it's a lot lighter, which makes it easier to transport, to mount, it's also flexible. So if you have, for instance, a rounded roof or something like that, you can easily make this work with the roof. Now, how you mount this depends on whether you want it to be a permanent install or a semi-permanent, if you think you might move it sometime in the future. A lot of people are just using a silicone bead along here, stick it straight to the roof or wherever they're putting it. Now, aside from the fact that this one is flexible and this one is rigid, what's the difference between these two panels? Well, to start with, this one is low voltage. This puts out maybe up to 20 volts, whereas this flexible panel here actually puts out 320 volts. That's higher than the voltage inside your house. Now, the reason for this high voltage is that it's meant primarily for grid tie. So rather than storing the power in a battery, you're going to put it straight into your existing grid inside your house. Obviously, it will drop the voltage down using a grid tie inverter. But that's why the voltage is so high. The good thing about high voltage, of course, is that you don't need such thick wires. So if you're going to do a long run between the roof and inside, you don't need to buy some really chunky cables. So that's the advantage of high voltage. Of course, it does make it a little bit more dangerous to work with, but you're going to put proper MC4 connectors on this panel anyway, so there's not really much danger, as long as you use a little bit of common sense and you don't try and, you know, touch both points at the same time or something crazy like that. Now, you might notice that there's actually no connectors on here, so you might be thinking, how do you connect this? Because on this panel, you have a junction box on the back, and then you have your positive and negative cable coming off, so nice and simple. If you're wondering, this is a 50 watt panel from CDR King. I'm still very happy with CDR King solar panels, so I do still recommend them. Their prices seem to be increasing a bit. I think they've realized that there's a high demand for their solar panels. And you know, they're changing models and then increasing the prices, but essentially it seems to be pretty much the same panels as before. So you know, I think they're really starting to cash in a bit on the fact that their solar panels were a lot cheaper than everyone else's. So how do you put the connectors on here? Well, each end is a wire, and you'll see that there's a bit of tape here. If I peel back the tape, you'll see the wire is exposed. So one end is negative, one end is positive. And what you have to do is solder your connectors onto here, and then you can either put a junction box like you see on the back of there onto here, or you can just use some kind of silicone or something like that to make a good seal with your connection. I'll pause the video and I'll go and grab one that I've already made. So QC policemen are over there. QC's finest. So here's one that I prepared earlier. You'll see, if you look underneath, you can see where the wire comes in, and I've joined on my cable. This is regular 4mm solar cable, which is suitable for outdoor use. And then I put an MC4 connection on the end. These are really great connections. They're a little bit pricey. They're not too bad, but compared to just, you know, homemade connections, these are a little bit more pricey. Maybe 150 peso per pair. The good thing about these is you crimp your connector on the inside, and then you put this enclosure over it, and it makes a really good watertight seal. And basically you have a male and a female, and when you join them together, you've got a really good outside suitable feel. Now what you'll see is I put some black silicone here, and that's the same silicone that you use on your windscreen. If you replace a windscreen, for example, that's the silicone that you're going to put there. So on each end, I put one of these connectors. And you see, what you'll do is you'll basically daisy chain these, with each panel will connect to the next one, and you're probably going to want to do it in parallel, since these panels are such high voltage. If you were to put it in series, you'd end up with a, you know, maybe 1,000 or higher volts, and that's not very workable unless you've got a really, really high-end inverter. So let's go ahead and test one of these, shall we? Thank you. QC policemen are over there. QC's finest. I always see them here by the monument, especially at night time when you get a lot of drag races coming around this area. So you see, I've just made that connection there. This would usually go to the next solar panel, but in this case I'm just going to connect directly to this to measure the voltage and of course the amps. Now it's not an especially sunny day, but that doesn't matter because I already know that these panels do output what they're meant to. So this is really just to show you the panel in action. I'm not even going to expand the panel to its full length because I want to keep it within the camera shot. So I'll just open it up a little bit. Okay, so let's get our multimeter. And let's start by measuring the voltage. Now it might be a little bit lower since I've folded over half of the panel, but let's just check anyway. So I'm measuring, I don't know if you'll be able to see this from there, but I'm measuring 317 volts. That's pretty high. It's not something that you'd really want to touch with your bare hands. So now let's measure the amps. Now, of course, this is going to be much lower than what it should be because, you know, it's a cloudy day and half of the panel is still folded up like this. Okay, so, oops, it's trying to roll away. I'm measuring 0.1 amp. So, you know, if you do 0.1 times 320, I'm not actually sure what the math is. I'll add that in afterwards. You might be wondering, what's the point of a flexible solar panel? Why not just stick with the regular solid ones? Well, these are especially suitable when you want to mount them somewhere that's unusual. For instance, if you had a bus roof, which is like this, then you could actually curve this whole panel to fit perfectly on there. It's also really easy to mount because you could just put a couple of beads of silicone around the edges and then stick it straight onto, say, a metal roof. It's super easy to mount. You could mount these in, you know, half a day, four panels, five panels more, you know, just in a few hours. So that's one of the benefits of these panels. They're also really lightweight if you need to transport them somewhere. That makes them very useful if you're like a really hardcore traveler, or if you're using them for a charity or disaster events, you can just put these in a car. You don't need to load up a van with heavy solar panels and, you know, worry about the glass breaking. You can just chuck these in the back of a car, take them to the site, hook it all up, and you're ready to roll. You know, you don't even have to mount these permanently. You could just lay them on the ground, put some rocks on the end, something like that, and boom, you've got instant power ready. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you have any questions, please leave them in the comments below. I apologize if the sound quality on this video isn't very good. I'm using this clip-on mic, but I broke the clip, so it's falling off all the time, and I'm hoping that once I go to edit this, it's all okay, but I'm a little bit worried. If you have any questions, or perhaps you have an idea about what you'd use this flexible solar panel for, leave it in the comments section, and please do remember to give a thumbs up and subscribe. Thanks for watching.